Drowning by Marny Javornik.
How did he do it? He must have some sort of fantastic radar to know when I was about to bail. I must give off some sort of pheromone, or maybe my eye started to twitch. And so here he was again, standing on my doorstep with a bottle of champagne and a bunch of my favourite flowers, a smooth smile on his face like nothing had happened. Of course I let him in, like the prize idiot I was. I just didn't have it in me to tell him to piss off on the doorstep. I had to keep telling myself, he must love me, otherwise why would he keep after me like this? Even after the shitty stunts he kept pulling that made me feel worthless and stupid, he must see something in me he loves, or he wouldn't keep coming back and showering me with affection until he did something that upset me, yet again. I thought last night had been the last straw. He'd come to pick me up and to go out to dinner. As soon as I opened the door, his eyes travelled up and down my body with a slight frown between his eyes, before uttering the classic phrase from him, "Is that what you're going to wear?" Instantly my self-esteem had plummeted as I stood rooted to the spot. I'd been feeling really good about the dress I'd chosen. It was a beautiful dark plum colour in a wraparound style that showed off a bit of cleavage, but not too much. He didn't like too much cleavage in public. It fell just below my knees, and I had matched it with some nude high heel pumps that I thought made my legs look a bit slimmer and longer. I glanced down at myself at a loss for words. When I raised my eyes again, he was still frowning and now looking at my face and hair. I snapped, "Don't say anything. Please, can we just go to dinner and relax for a change?" He sighed and turned back to his car, not waiting for me to lock the door behind me and trot towards the passenger door of the car. As usual, he didn't wait for me to shut the door before the engine was on and he was pulling away from the curb. Great, I thought. It's going to be one of those excruciating evenings where he has a bug up his bum and I would have to endure whatever he threw my way, because we were in public and my mother raised me to be polite in public and not cause a scene. At the restaurant, things went downhill rapidly. He ignored me and ordered for me a soup and a salad, no dessert because I'd put on a few pounds, according to him. He ordered a bottle of white wine, which always gives me a headache, and talked about how well he was doing at his work and the promotion he was sure he was going to get. I sat there like a robot, eating and sipping at the wine while nodding at appropriate moments. He didn't need me to say anything. He had enough conversation for the two of us. To top the evening off, when he dropped me off at home, he had been quite insistent about coming inside, and I had been equally insistent that I was tired and just wanted to go to bed, alone. He'd got snippy about that too and made some comment about what a waste of time the dinner had been then, before tromping back to his car and revving the engine before taking off. Exhausted, I'd completed my usual nightly routine before slipping between the sheets, laying on my side and thinking about how I'd come to this point. It seemed he gave me just enough to keep me hanging in there with him. He could be charming and romantic, but it was always on his terms, I thought. He somehow managed to keep me hoping that things would improve, that he wasn't all bad. But in reality, he truly was the worst. The worst for me and my self-esteem. I hated that he kept me hanging, not calling me for days and then popping up out of the blue and expecting me to drop everything to be available for him and what he wanted to do. Why couldn't I just tell him where to go and just get out on with my life? How could I let myself be so easily manipulated by him and his hot and cold attitude? I felt trapped. I felt like I was stuck, unable to move forward. It had to stop, and I was going to tell him tomorrow, I had told myself. And now here he is in front of me, in my living room, with the champagne and flowers after yet another horrible date the night before. I was drowning, but I could save myself if I really wanted to. Taking a deep breath, I looked directly into his eyes and started, "Warren, we need to talk about us."